Hello everyone, my name is Kevin Bost. I'm a GitKraken Ambassador and Microsoft MVP. And today I'm going to be showing you how to use the Git Revert command. The Git Revert command is used to undo or revert a prior change that you've made in your repository. It is typically the best command to fix past mistakes as it doesn't go back and change your Git history. Rather, it is a forward change command. What that means is when you use Git Revert, it will create a mirror commit that negates the effects of your prior commit. To say it another way, it'll create an inverse commit that effectively undoes your prior change. Let's take a look at what that looks like. Okay, let's take a look at the Git Revert command in action. Here I have a feature branch that I've been working on a very simple little website. It's just going through and adding in my good pal Robert. So this is a fairly simple HTML page. My good friend, Dr. Robert Frankenstein, who also apparently loves GitKraken, which is great, figured I would add him to this page. You can see I've got a couple commits here and an open pull request. If we go in and look at the file changes, you can see there's a few changes to the HTML page themselves, a key change here adding in the image, and then we can see the image gets added. Great, nothing fancy. But when looking at the PR, there's a comment on here saying, hey, can you please remove the picture of Robert? It's a little distracting. I get it. He's got a flashy hat, big green coat. It is a little distracting. But how do we go through and actually get that change back out now that we've already done it? If we look through our list of commits, we can see that this commit here is actually the one where the Robert PNG file was added to the commit, the little picture there, as well as the change in the HTML. Inside of GitKraken, it's really easy to revert. You simply right-click on the commit and go down to Revert Commit. And it'll give you a quick prompt asking you, do you want to immediately convert these changes or would you like them added to your working changes? We'll show both really quick. If I hit no, I get the inverse or the mirror commit that is effectively undoing the prior commit here. If I look at the changes, I can see that it's undoing the change from team.png or undoing the change that I previously made to Robert PNG from Team PNG, and then it's deleting the file itself. We can go ahead and throw these things away. If I go back and actually revert the commit and say yes, immediately commit the changes, it effectively does the exact same thing, except for rather than leaving them as pending, it automatically creates a commit for me, sets a default message. I get the same set of changes inside of here, but it automatically made the commit and it's ready to push. Okay, let's take a look at what this might look like in the terminal. I have the terminal pane open inside of GitKraken. I'm leaving the history graph visible just so that we have a nice representation of what is actually happening as we execute our commands. In order to do a Git revert, the thing that you will need is the commit hash of the commit that you want to get rid of. Just like before, I've got a feature branch with a few commits on it, and it's this updating to use a picture of Robert. But if we didn't have this nice GUI sitting here, we might use something like git log to view a list of the commits that have occurred on our branch. And we can see that this commit here, the 7AC5DC commit, is the one that contains updating to use a picture of Robert. With most git commands on the command line, you only have to specify enough of the commit hash to make it unique, which is usually about 6-ish characters in a lot of situations. We're just going to grab the first 6 there and then press Q to get out. To execute the git revert, we're going to go git revert and then go ahead and paste in that commit hash. You can see that it has updated our work in progress. We've got some changes that look just like our revert commit before, undoing. And then it automatically opened up the editor, in this case VI, to give us an opportunity to edit that commit message. I'm just going to take the commit message as it stands. So colon QA gets us out, enter. And you can see that now we have a revert commit created for us, undoing our prior changes. And we could certainly go ahead and push this to the branch. I'm going to actually just undo this really quick, just so that we can show off a few other features on the command line. One of the other things that we can do on the git revert, just like how GitKraken gave us that option to just automatically revert without popping that editor to do the message, we can do the same thing on the command line. There's a dash dash no edit option where it'll do effectively the same thing as what we just saw a moment ago. But instead of popping vi up to go through and type that message, if you're just wanting to take the default of, you know, reverting the prior commit, great, you can do a dash no edit there, and you can see it automatically went through and made the new commit for me. The other one that might be useful to know about, just like how in the GitKraken client, we had that menu that opened up for us that gave us the choice of, hey, do you want to automatically create a commit or do you just want to leave this as working changes? There is a Git revert option for that as well. Instead of no edit, it's going to be no commit. And then you can see that we have our changes. They are effectively that mirror inverse of our original commit, but rather than already packaged up in a nice commit for us, they're just sitting in our stage files. We can choose to make additional changes to it, go through, undo parts of it if we wanted to, get it in the right state before we actually go through and make that commit. We're just going to go ahead and undo those real quick. The last thing that I wanted to show is on the command line, there's actually a nicer feature where if you want to commit a range of commits rather than just one at a time, you can do that here. So let's imagine that we want to do both of these commits. So not just the picture of Robert, but also revert the updating title of page. We've decided that both of those changes we don't want. So once again, we're going to take a quick look at the Git log to get the commit hash that we need. So in this case, 9B7FD0. I'm going to go ahead and copy that one as well. Go ahead and press Q. And then we can do a Git revert. And then you do the older commit hash that you want. So that same 7AC, because this one is the older of the two. And then we go ahead and do the newer of the commit hashes right there. And then once again, we can also do the no edit if we just want to have it automatically create those commits for us. And what it ends up doing is it goes through each of those commits in order and one at a time creates a revert commit. Now, obviously, when you're doing these revert commits, conflicts and things can occur. You always have to deal with those things with Git. But hopefully this gives you a nice handle on how to do the Git revert on the command line. Okay, and there you have it. That's all it takes to use the Git revert command. If you want an even more in-depth example, there'll be a blog post link down in the description below. If you're interested in more videos like this, I do a lot of live coding here on YouTube, as well as over on Twitch. You can see the links up there, as well as links down in the description as well. Typically do a lot of C#.NET with a little bit of Azure and whatever else strikes my fancy kind of thrown in there as the days go through. With that, tell everyone happy coding. Thank you for watching.